here at the State Capitol. We're with Nakayo right now, and she's one of the youth members who helped put this whole organization together, this whole movement together. How was it putting this movement together?
Sometimes it did get pretty stressful, just because we wanted to make sure that it was as safe and as positive as possible. Overall, we're really happy with the turnout. We honestly couldn't have done anything else different.
How long did it take you folks to organize this?
So we've been working on this for about 2 weeks. We first started off just as high schoolers having an idea, especially this week where it really took off, and we started working with Corona Care and the Duck Providing Food and Target for Water. It really took off this week where we actually were like, wait, we actually are doing this. We actually are doing it wrong.
What kind of long-term solutions do you have in mind with this whole situation that's happening?
Personally, one of the main ones that's popular here is defunding the police. We don't believe that the police really should be getting this much money, that money should be allocated to our communities, should be allocated to our impoverished areas. Poverty is a big determiner of crime. And if you give those people the resources to grow out of their areas, you're going to see a drastic decrease in the amount of crime.
Have you yourself experienced racism here in Hawaii?
I myself have not experienced racism here in Hawaii. I am not from Hawaii personally. I grew up in Elizabethtown, Kentucky. And but I did experience racism there just because it's predominantly white area. Here, all I can get is love and support, but it's still important that we use our voices and advocate here and show the Black brothers and sisters on the continent that they have.
What are some of the resources that people or the listeners can turn to for some help or for some assistance?
Personally, we suggest probably going to the Black Lives Matter chapter. They are always giving out different petitions and different things to sign. ACLU is currently doing a big lawsuit against administrations for doing a lot of things that we didn't necessarily think was within their constitutional rights. We definitely encourage people to sign petitions, especially all the change ones, especially Breonna Taylor. Breonna Taylor still needs thousands of signatures on her petition. Just reach out to people. There's tons of resources, tons of people to sign, tons of places to donate to the National Rail Fund. Just educate yourself and you will find something that's right for you.